Hello everyone, it is Evan here from The Trade Risk, and in this short video, I want to talk about conditional colors in TC2000. So traditionally, we look at a price series chart and we've got green and red bars. We've got red for down days, green for up days. But you can actually change that and you can modify the color of your bars based on certain conditions. And I want to show you how to do it right now. So if you follow my mouse up here, what you're going to want to do first is click the drop down of the price series that you're looking at. You're going to click on edit. And when you open up this chart properties window, if you go all the way towards the bottom here, there is a section called conditional colors. And so if you click on add color, you're gonna get presented with a easy scan condition library selection choice. And so what I'm gonna do just to illustrate this, I'm gonna write my own formula, but you can use anything that you have pre-built or you can use the drop-down menu. I'm just very comfortable with the PCF syntax. So what I'm gonna do is color the bars based on heavy volume. So let's just say we wanna track volume that is greater than the average 50-day volume. Right? If that occurs, we want the bar of our chart to turn a certain color. And so as soon as I type that in, that's the code for it. I'm going to click on OK. And then I'm going to click this drop down and I'm going to say, you know what? I want to see yellow when this occurs. And so you can see here that this is actually occurring quite a bit, right? Most of the price series is actually yellow now. And what that's telling you is that is the positive confirmation of the condition we just wrote. So all of these yellow bars are telling us that that is an above average volume day. And so you can see it here. If you just look right down and we look at volume here, you can see that all of these yellow bars are in fact happening on above average volume. You can see that this is happening so much that it's not that helpful. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back into my edit conditions here and I'm going to say, you know what, this needs to be 2 times the average 50-day volume. And you can see there's a lot less yellow on this chart. In fact, the only yellow that I can see right now is right back in here, March 2023. Take a look at these volume bars down here. So you can clearly see this was a significant day. So you can see that the big volume traded, this is proving positive that this condition coloring of the chart only when there's 2x volume is in fact working. So it's a cool little hack. Now I want to take another condition here and I want to do it a slightly different way. So what I often do when I'm testing things or I just want to see very clearly the conditions that are happening is I'll go to the price series. So I've got a new chart open here. And what I do is I actually change the up bars and the down bars to go to white. All right. And so that just gives me this boring clean slate here. And it's just basically tracking price. But then I will put on my condition that I want to see happen. So in this case, I'm going to click on the add colors button. I'm going to write my own formula. And in this situation, I'm just going to say if price is above the 50-day, the average 50-day moving average, then I want a color and I want it to be green. And what we can see here is that the bars are now in most cases a lot of green here. And this is signaling that every time a green bar is present, the price series is above a 50 period simple moving average. And again, this works on every time frame. So if I go down to a 65 minute chart or 15 minute chart, or of course I can change symbols and go to Apple, right? And this will automatically be applied to everything I'm looking at. But this is now showing every time Apple's above a 50 SMA, print it green. And you can of course do the opposite or the bearish. So if close is less than average close of 50, we can put that red. And now suddenly we've got this red and green chart, but it is not based on what the candle close was that session. It's based entirely on our conditions because we have them suited in, you know, basically covering all scenarios. So I think that's pretty cool. You can notice that there isn't up and down. So there's actually an order that matters here. And the reason why you'd want to change the order is because you're going to have competing conditions or you're going to have overlapping conditions. Whatever is at the top is going to take precedent. So for instance, you had heavy volume was a color and above a 50 SMA. depending on the order here, you would stack them and the bars would get printed based on the order that you put them in. A couple of other things I do with this. So for instance, if we go to this chart here. So again, this is the white price series chart, which you can see here. And this is much more selective. And what this is this is our custom MACD divergence indicator. So anytime our indicator, which is tracking and looking for momentum divergences with price series versus MACD, this is one of our pre-built indicators in our store on traderisk.com, it'll print red, it'll print a dot, and it'll color the bars as well. So for instance, I'll look at this when I just quickly want to see, and I'll go through a big watch list of charts very fast and be able to very easily identify when there is visual confirmation of the conditions I want to see. So you could go through, you know, XLK, go back here, right? And we see, okay, nice divergence set up here at the September lows, nice rally off of it, September lows in October, or I'm sorry, October lows, nice rally came off of it, bearish divergence in July. You know, you can go right down the list, look at Tesla, not too much happening here, a couple of bear signals right near top. So it's a cool indicator of ours, but it also signifies sort of conditional colors here on how to use it pretty nicely. Last but not least is you can do this with indicators as well. So let's just go back to a clean chart here. We'll go to the SPY and notice here I have a 50 period simple moving average on my chart, and you can see that, and that's that green line and red line, and it's color coded because I have conditions in here to, let's just open it up, print green or red based on whether or not the simple moving average is rising or if it's declining. So we've got a 50 period simple moving average. If it's rising, it's going to be printed green. If it's declining, it's going to be printed red. And this is also kind of helpful. It's cool that you can do this with indicators as well. And as long as you have the code that you can sort of, you know, define what you're looking for in your conditions. And these conditions can be very complicated. You can have 5, 6, 7, 8 different rules here. That's totally fine, but it will work. And you'll just want to stack them in the order of importance and you'll be good to go. So I hope you found this video helpful. Cool little hack there. I like to use it just for testing things and you know, trading and spotting opportunities that I want to see visually sort of laid out in my chart. Very helpful. So if you have any questions, leave a comment below. We've got a lot more custom indicators, stock scans, all kinds of cool stuff for Worden TC2000. Check the description in this video or just head to thetraderisk.com, see everything that we have. If you need any help with custom coding or building your own conditions, let us know. We do that on a day-to-day basis. So hope you enjoyed and we'll see you back here in another video. Take care.